Hello and welcome to Masterworks 2021,
a showcase of work from our 8th grade graduating class.
If you want to dig deeper into any of these projects,
go to blackpinecircle.org/masterworks2021.
blackpinecircle.org/masterworks2021.
But first up, this can't wait until the end. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
To all the Masterworks advisors, and especially Ms. Mitchell and Mr. Cohen.
You provided so much support and guidance throughout this school year with these projects and so much more.
Thank you.
Let's get into it. This first project is from Charlie DZ, who studied photography and took over 300 photos around Oakland, San Francisco, as well as in Joshua Tree. Of those, 47 made the cut for his final website, desordophotography.squarespace.com. Charlie learned about camera setting and realized that he now notices more of his surroundings. Love it.
Meyer made a music-themed card game and a custom deck to go with it. For the project, Meyer researched game design, used Photoshop, and turned his designs into an actual physical deck. Meyer, great job.
Cleo's goal was to make a film as a way of experimenting with different styles, like stop motion and special effects. This goal resulted in several shorts that speak for themselves.
Oliver B. made a board game about all the crazy things that happened in 2020. Players choose their political party before the game starts, and various colors correspond to a player's mental health, financial health, and physical health. A lot of thought went into this one, and it's totally relatable. Thanks, Oliver.
Nate focused on improving his drawing ability. He worked with pen, pencil, paper, and a digital drawing tablet. He learned that drawing, as with any skill, the more you practice, the better you get. Very nice, Nate.
Remy and Jonah partnered up because of their shared love for skateboarding and made a mini skate park. They learned a lot and kick-flipped their way over many challenges. They made a box, a rail, a kicker. Here they are testing it out.
Joseph focused on woodblock printing and learned how to create an art piece using different components and methods. He says it was a fun challenge to figure out how to layer his creations and gained a respect for how difficult it would be to create a more complex print. Very impressive, Joseph.
Amron created a hand-sewn blanket from felt and fabric and learned the time-consuming process of such a project. She learned that each piece of fabric has a different type of thread and needle used for it and how to make clean seams by sewing inside out. Looking good, Amron.
Isabel studied and grew Bay Area native plants, attracting many bees, butterflies, and birds to her garden. She learned that plants need perfect conditions to grow and require thorough research prior to planting. Patience is another requirement. Check out Isabel's slide for some incredibly helpful tips and link to other resources.
One of our three Olivers, Oliver H.U., set out to write a novel and successfully completed part one of a science fiction fantasy book. It is the story of a boy who finds himself in a magical factory where stories are made and has a perilous journey in hopes of returning home. During his journey as an author, Oliver learned how to stay motivated, more about the editing process, and ways of elaborating on ideas. Sounds like a great adventure.
Sam got to know himself as a songwriter and learned he preferred writing over performing. He shared his progress with friends and allowed their feedback to enhance his final production. Have a listen.
Now I will run this, please pass me the baton. Want cheese like Parmesan, don't we all, that's so true. And liberty, that's mutual, just like that email.
Thanks, Sam.
In Adam's gardening and landscaping project, he learned about crop growth, climate, irrigation, and of course, Murphy's Law. During the process, he found the need for a retaining wall and took on that challenge as part of the process. Way to go, Adam.
OHOD's magnetic launching system is a prototype that models levitating an aircraft on a platform using magnets, allowing for fuel conservation and more efficient maneuvers. The cost and resource savings involved in greater fuel efficiency upon takeoff and landing are aiming at reducing an airline's negative environmental impact.
Livia dedicated her masterwork to learning about beauty standards for women in the fashion, makeup, and modeling industries and how they affect girls and women. She interviewed women in the industry and responded to her research with works of art and song as a way of expressing the impact this study had on her.
Rose took on the task of working with 35mm film in her single-lens reflex film camera. While learning the more technical side of how to operate the camera, she also studied the history of photography. Be sure to check out the slideshow with a link to Rose's finished prints. Great job, Rose!
So for my project, I took to the streets of Berkeley to meet unhoused people and learn about their experiences and what it's like to be homeless in Berkeley. I met 7 houseless people and a bunch of different social workers. Everyone who I talked to was super cool, and I learned about both their experiences, their life story, and just other totally random things. This process debunked a lot of biases and stereotypes that I hadn't even known I had. I wrote about all of this, including my first time in People's Park, in my book, which I encourage you to check out an excerpt from on the website. I think the biggest life lesson that I learned was that one of the best and easiest ways to help a houseless person every day is just to make eye contact, smile, and say hi.
Charlie B built the mechanical keyboard, the project demanding learning many new concepts and skills for him to complete. He learned how to solder, how to create a silicone mold and a resin cast, and how to disassemble and loop key switches. In the end, he was able to overcome many challenges, and the outcome was a functioning product.
Shake learned to compose in the style of 3 classical composers, Chopin, Bach, and Mozart. He researched by listening to their music and researching their life and process. He characterized Bach as using a lot of sixths and thirds, Mozart as being light and quick, and Chopin as romantic, slower minor songs and faster major songs. Here is one of his songs in the style of Chopin.
Made his own skateboards and hand planes using a vacuum press, foam molds, and maple wood. The results look great, and you learn many woodworking skills along the way to use in future projects. Great job, Andrew.
My masterwork, I set out to draw an animation about climate change. I've always been an artist, but want to expand my skills. The project contains over 140 frames and multiple layers. My father would always tell me that perfect is the enemy of progress, which allowed me to move forward and let go of focusing on details and perfecting. Francis created frames, characters, and places from Green Glass House by Kate Milford. This project took him in new directions as he explored, such as digital art, watercolor. As he took inspiration from stained glass design, he really brought the book to life.
Nella researched and designed a surfboard. She sanded, reshaped, and glassed her board, and not only learned to do all this from scratch, but learned how to repair damage to existing boards in the future. She goes into great detail in her slideshow, so do check that out at blackpinecycle.org/masterworks2021.
Jeremy took on his passion for cycling and recreated an Olympic mountain bike course in Tilden Park. As he did this, he recorded and plotted his own performance and training. He found the value of persevering and pushing himself to never give up. Great job, Jeremy.
While Jeremy was cycling past oak trees in Tilden, Sadie C. was studying the history of Native Californians' use of acorns.
So something that I didn't explain very well in my slides is how this whole acorn right here goes from being like this to being like this, like what the actual process is. I start out with this whole acorn right here, crack it, get the shell off with my fingernails. You have to winnow them. Now I have a big basket here that I use for it. They rub together and the skins kind of fall off. Then they are ready to be ground and you just smash them up until they turn into a powder that is about the consistency that you'd expect from flour. Once you've done that, you get a powder that looks kind of like this finished flour here, but a little more yellow. And you can't be done yet because it's still full of a compound called tannins. So what you have to do is you have to leach it. And what I made is this thing right here. It's a bucket. There's a pond pump in there. There's bags of the acorn flour are right here. Hose from the pond pump goes out of the bucket. There's dowels up here that the bags hang into the water from. So basically there's bag hanging water to the flour, and the water gets circulated around, which leaches the tannins out. I actually went through 4 different iterations of this before I got to what I have right here. So basically after that, you put it on baking sheets and let it dry in the sun until it looks like, well, this, like flour. And after that, you can cook with it. I've made pancakes and cookies with it. They're pretty good, although it does have a flavor that not everybody likes. So if you try this at home, be warned. Also, it's not good for people who are allergic to nuts. But if you want to try this at home, all you need to do is get an acorn. It's some acorns and a mortar and pestle. Or if you don't want to do that, you can find something that is similar but not quite the same, called acorn starch at most Korean markets. But anyway, that is how you make acorn flour.
Tasty.
Eli constructed a pinball machine from scratch. He wanted to learn more about electronics, microcontrollers, construction, and engineering, and this is a perfect project to make use of those skills. He found that building a pinball machine was quite difficult, as you might imagine, and that very few people would attempt to build from scratch. Incredible.
Ben built it on a board game called Penguin Dash. In it, the player has to move their penguin around obstacles and through water. The goal was to make a complicated game that will leave a player wanting to play again. Ben discovered that making a good game board is harder than it looks, and that a theme and story are important for sustaining interest in a game. I want to play!
August used an electric guitar kit to build and paint his own electric guitar. This required building a painting booth in his garage, as well as cutting and redesigning parts of the kit he didn't like. He learned a lot from this project, mostly from the mistakes, and feels his technique was greatly improved. Rock and roll, August.
Leo made a comic book about drawing. His goal was to make it easy to understand, but also not overly simplified. While translating how to draw to the page, he also learned more about the scope of what might be considered art, and how various techniques are used to achieve different outcomes. Looks really nice, Leo.
Amaya's project is titled Korean corn dog experiment? Wait, did I read that right? Yep. Okay, Maya studied recipes, learned how to deep fry, how to work with yeast, and how to proof dough. The results look delicious.
Julia wrote an 18-page biography about Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez that included in an original work of art of AOC. She gained insight into how to organize her thoughts, specifically for writing nonfiction, and Julia explains how Ocasio-Cortez's past and upbringing uniquely positioned her to represent her community.
Augie got deeper into the world of tarot cards in order to learn how to read and understand them. He also created a tarot card of his own. Augie says that he's so glad to have had the opportunity to learn about this tool that people have used in their daily lives.
Miles learned about cartography while making several maps of his own. Miles's maps focused on current events and issues such as wildfires and COVID-19. Here's a time lapse of a map showing COVID-19's disproportionate effect on minorities and lower income populations in Los Angeles County.
For Keelan's project, he built a wooden chessboard and a box to hold the pieces. Keelan's been interested in chess for a long time and thought that it'd be a good idea to build his own board. Nice work, Keelan.
Willa's vegan cookbook comes complete with original drawings on each recipe. Fennel the Frog is the star of the show. Willa started her project by creating an end goal and planned the steps to get her to that end. Amazing! The recipes were compiled only after extensive character design of Fennel the Frog. A deliciously cool idea, Willa.
Sarah Jane interviewed people about what they have been doing and what they have learned during the pandemic. She took the information she gathered and compiled it into a book, along with portraits of her subjects. She not only learned about taking photos, but also studied techniques for allowing her subjects to open up to her with stories. What a fascinating project. Can't wait to see it.
Check out the slideshow at blackpinecircle.org/masterworks2028's website devoted to animal rights and protecting endangered species. Her study was inspired by a documentary that she saw several years ago about the northern white rhino and how poaching drove them to near extinction. There are only two females left. Kate understood that in order to change something, one must teach others about it first. So she made a website about endangered animals and farms, teaching people about animals and animal rights.
Sadie B worked to make jigsaw puzzles. At first, she had only planned on making one or two really detailed puzzles, but in the end, she made four puzzles. The process is interesting, to be sure to check it out.
How far are we into the show, and this is the first we've heard about a project with Minecraft? Amazing. Jagger designed a game in Minecraft requiring him to study core mechanics of the game. As he brainstormed and researched, here's a tour of part of his game.
I came up with this whole idea for the game while I was reading 1984 for English class, and it gave me inspiration for a sort of dystopian-based game set in the future. So here you should see I start in front of my classroom, and there's an android nearby, which is like one of the assistant, like they used to assist people in this world. So you go over, go chat to him by hitting this button. Hello, student. They ask you if you've seen anyone suspicious, so you respond to them. They give you an objective, look out for darkly dressed people while at school. So now you're wandering around school, you know, viewing the park, and you notice that there's some people, just very suspicious people on the basketball court. So you start to walk over to them, see what's going on. And something manages to slip into your pocket amidst all of the chaos in that cutscene. So then you get given this little booklet, and you look through the book, you look through this, and you hit this thing when you're done. And by hitting that, the level's completed, and you're teleported back to the main lobby where you can go between the different levels. So, that was a little snippet of my game. Hope you enjoyed, and have a good day.
Thanks, Jagger.
I've always had an interest in wilderness survival. There's always been something exciting, fun, and risky about sleeping and surviving in the wilderness. My original project was to go out into the wilderness and survive for 24 hours. Due to COVID and various closures, I decided to focus on survival skills and preparing for natural disasters.
If you love candy, talk to Finn, who made hard candy, cotton candy, Twix, caramels, and even jalapeno candy. Finn's stated goal was to expand his knowledge on candy, how it's made, and learn how to make it. He learned that making candy is sort of like a science experiment.
Kira opened an Etsy shop and sold her watercolors. The goal was not only to learn more about having an online storefront, but to improve her watercoloring skills. She learned about scanning, printing, ink, and paper quality and packaging. The project will extend beyond her time at BPC as she hopes to expand her skills and her inventory.
Malcolm took an idea from Minecraft and brought it into the physical world with his real-life shulker box. The aim was to have it open and closed on command, and the final result came close to his goal.
Carly learned and practiced calligraphy and other hand lettering fonts and styles. Calligraphy took time to learn, but she also practiced about 12 fonts and chose her 5 favorite to make into a reference book for future use when journaling. Beautiful!
Syra created her own makeup line. Her hope was to share this with friends and families so that they could try it out and review it. It took multiple tries before getting the perfect consistency. She learned what it takes to have a makeup line and realized the reality of potential startup costs for such a business.
Oliver H.I. learned to make, sharpen, and throw knives. The main idea was to learn how to make and take care of knives. The hardest part was probably throwing knives. Throwing knives is actually a lot harder than throwing axes, says Oliver, as an axe is more forgiveness and spins slower and more predictably. I'll keep that in mind.
Eloise and I both have an interest in art, specifically digital art and animation. As we researched our favorite animes and cartoons, one of the first things we learned was that animation is hard. A steady hand is extremely important when trying to recreate the background, exactly the same as the last one. We also figured that it would be good to go into more of an analysis about the stereotypes in the media and how harmful they can be. Thanks.
Colin studied 3D modular origami, starting with basic shapes like squares and working his way up to an isosahedron, which is a 12-faced shape. After many hours of what Colin describes as reading, folding, and error, he had over 50 pieces. Looks great, Colin. Your favorite YouTuber, Birdie Betts, is actually our very own Emmanuel. Can you believe it? For his masterworks, he studied various production techniques that might enhance his already popular show. He focused on lighting techniques as well as post-production color correction. He learned a ton, and the results look great.
It's no surprise that for Emmett's project, he built a road bike from scratch. Let's see what you did, Emmett.
So this here is the bike that I built for my masterwork project, and it was a heck of a journey. It's quite a nice bike. It works for me while commuting to school every day. And actually my old bike got stolen right after I finished this bike, so it was quite lucky that I built it. So yeah, this was my masterwork project, and it's a great working bike.
Quinn set out with a goal to record a demo of original songs. She realized how challenging producing an album can be. The end result of what is shared on the slideshow is just perfect.
Pretty beetles with lots of different dots. Little ladybugs with lots of different spots. We all have different dots. Never to the same. Spots and our dots make us who we are. So why do we wanna change?
Nice work, Quinn.
Rose's goal was to construct a natural and compact water filter for backpacking, hiking, and camping. With a bit of research, ingenuity, and some gravel, sand, and charcoal, she had a tool to keep her hydrated and healthy out in the world. Great job, Rose.
Sophia collected family recipes and made a cookbook. Through the course of working on the book, she made every recipe she collected to be sure they're up to her standards. She said that it's great to follow instructions, but if you improvise, you might like the results better. She also researched binding methods used between the 5th and 15th century to figuratively and literally tie her project together. Thanks, Sophia.
Speaking of time together, Helen studied hair braiding and history techniques for the 25,000-year-old Venus of Willendorf all the ways to the present. Braiding has a rich history, and Helen covered it all. She learned how braids are culturally significant and discovered methods and techniques for braiding hair.
Arson's Masterwork Project was an international cookbook of people's favorite childhood dishes from when they were 13. He held interviews with family friends from around the world over Zoom, and they talked about the recipe and their memory regarding the dish. Arson then cooked each dish, took photos, and compiled his book. What a delicious and meaningful project. Great job, Arson.
Did you know that there are more microorganisms in 1 teaspoon of soil than there are people on Earth? Well, Aliana does. And she learned this fact and many others while redesigning and landscaping a part of her front yard. From plant and soil health to planning and just plain old digging, Aliana left no stone unturned, and the results are beautiful.
It's a reoccurring theme of these projects that trial and error leads to new discoveries and realizations. This is also the case when Alex embarked on a journey to make a solar cell. His goal was to gain an understanding of the principle and not necessarily to power something at this stage. In the end, the cell produced 60 microamps. For comparison, a AA battery produces 1.5 million microamps. Shocking.
Linka made a cookbook full of recipes for her family, some of which had only been passed down by word of mouth until now. She learned how to make many dishes, but more importantly, how to write and record a recipe. She learned that improvisation is a big part of cooking because they are unique to your taste, not just something you can copy. Yum.
Dylan is here to tell us about his beehive project.
So this is a little bird comb. You can see there's bees. This is a, right here is a pollen patty. What it is there's paper on the outside and pollen on the inside. They love this stuff. And they're eating away at it, you can see. They eat the paper too, which is amazing. They're building comb all around here. They've stayed kind of this way so far, which isn't really a bad thing.
At the front of the box, near the entrance, right?
Yeah, but they're gonna start building down this way. Once they fill up a frame, we can move that to the outside, so then they'll build up these frames too. This is called the bottom board. Okay. And it catches all the debris that falls down from the hive. So you can see, you can tell a lot about the beehive from what's down here on the bottom board. So if you look, it also can catch mites. And you wanna know whether you have a mite problem. Because what they do is they go up in the hive and then they lay eggs in the bees' cells and then they eat the bees' resources, so you don't want that happening. This a lot of comb production here, which we can see there's some nice pollen, different colors too, and I think that they've been laying eggs for a little bit now, so, and I don't see anything creeping or crawling or any little black dots, which are mites, which is all really good signs. So I'm gonna brush this up. This is a little example of what they're building, and it's amazing. Look at how geometric it is. This piece fell off, so we rubber banded it into place, and they'll get to it. You don't have to worry about that, but this is just an example of what they're doing. And like this whole frame will be filled up by the time we're ready to start harvesting some honey. In about 8 to 10 months, because this is like, they're happy here. This is the time of year for them to start building up resources and like really just constructing the hive. That's why we got them when we did. And so then they're gonna like go into a little bit, it's called a dearth period, which is the winter. And then like after that, during the spring and the summer, then maybe we can start harvesting honey next year. You can see like in the bottom of some of these, specifically like right there, down there, there's some honey. Like it glows a little bit, which is also a really good sign. They're very gentle bees. They don't want to sting you, that's what you have to remember.
Raphael wanted to learn how to code in Java, and that's just what he did. he enrolled in a course and created a game to practice. Along the way, he discovered that learning one coding language makes it easier to learn a new one. Congratulations, Raphael.
Milana set out to choreograph a dance, perform it, film it, and put together a video of it. Here is her finished piece, performed to Winter Song by Sarah Barry Ellis and Ingrid Michelson.
Is love alive? Is love alive? Is love alive? This is my winter song. December never felt so wrong. 'Cause you're not where you belong. Inside my
Thanks for watching! Bye!
And be sure to check out presentations for more details.
Go to blackpinecircle.org/masterworks2020.
Goodbye!